Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Today we have almost no new standard SpaceX updates, so we'll be checking out a lot of infrastructure and Starship updates in Boca Chica. So let's head straight in and get up to date. Before we head over to Boca Chica, I'll reiterate that SpaceX is probably going to be launching Starlink 12 tomorrow, Thursday 17th. As you can see on the SpaceXFans website, we can currently expect the launch at 6:17pm UTC or 2:17pm EDT. SpaceX has apparently filed with the FCC to install 10 Starlink user terminals on up to 10 SpaceX sea vessels, including the drone ships. They also want to install it on a bunch of other ships, presumably the GO vessels. Whilst Falcon 9 will lift off from Florida, over in Texas, SpaceX have installed the final of 6 sleeves for the new launch mount. We've recently seen the new bunkers that are complete, but SpaceX are in the process of constructing more. When we last saw these, it was just the foundations, now you can see the walls coming together. They've also been doing further work on the launch mounts, here you can see them moving what looks to be pipes around. Over in the production yard, a new piece for some launch infrastructure was spotted with this new component for the ground support equipment. Of course, as always, there's also the new high bay which continues to be worked on. They are now about halfway up the structure with the walls. Onto some tweets from Elon Musk about Starships. To start with, we have a tweet in response to an animation of SN8 landing. He responded with, "Pretty accurate simulation, although SN8 will use 3 Raptors. If SN8 craters, SN9 and SN10 are close behind. High production rate allows for faster iteration." In response, somebody tweeted at Musk again, asking what serial number Starship he thinks will reach orbit first. Musk responded to say, "Just a guess, but probably mid-teens. I think he meant tens. Booster and stacking on orbital pad are likely limiting factors. We'll build several ships just to improve the production system." So, looking at more pieces for future Starship serial numbers, here you can see some brand new fins have arrived. You can see them lying on the ground right now. Whilst we've had a bunch of new components arrive recently, they are definitely wanting some more soon with the rate they are building Starships. So with this speed, they also need more components to actually get the tanks off the ground. You can see that another thrust puck and further legs were seen sitting on the back of a trailer waiting to be unloaded. Also spotted in a construction yard, we have an interesting new piece we've not seen before. Apparently, this is the attachment point for the fins to the body of Starship. Moving onto the tank, currently doing some rounds of testing, after being moved onto the test mount, SN7.1 was worked on some more. It was being prepared for what would be a cryogenic pressure test a matter of days later. We have some footage from Maria Pointer where SN7.1 did a cryogenic pressure test early in the morning on Tuesday 15th of September. Whilst the idea for SN7.1 was to be tested to destruction, it lives on for now. They also did 2 more tests yesterday evening and really early this morning, still with no pop. Cameron County still has a road closure date for tomorrow. Then they also still have further back updates on Monday and Tuesday. With SN7.1 testing happening in the launch area, engineers are still working on SN8 in the construction area. You can see that they have installed those new aero surface covers for the fins on SN8. We are getting very close to the first full-size Starship since Mark 1, I just can't wait. I'm just going to throw this in here, but this is the latest SN8 build diagram from Brendan Lewis. Moving on from this and onto the next Starship which will be put together soon, we have SN9. Starting with this thrust section stack that was seen moved outside behind the tents. This section has also been flipped so it's in the correct orientation. Next, this ring stack will be hooked up to another smaller stack which is the engine skirt to form the aft section. After the flip, it was moved back inside a fabrication tent, probably for some more work. Another ring stack was spotted sitting just inside the tent, this is presumably for SN9 also. With SN8 already stacked and the pace at which SpaceX are currently pumping out sections, they are looking to also have SN9 ready soon. You can see the ring stack, I believe is from the last episode with lead-ins, has been moved outside. This is the midsection for the liquid oxygen tank. The ring stack was then seen being hooked up to a crane in order to be lifted and moved. So finally it was moved over to and placed inside the mid bay along with the stacked SN8 tank. You can also see that the next part of the LOX tank for SN9 has already been stacked in the mid bay. Assuming SN9 will be built like SN8, we should see the upper bulkhead for the methane tank next, then the thrust section. Based on the SN8 timeline, it might take a month for them to get it all stacked. However, with this pace, I'm hoping they'll try and get it stacked quicker. The last thing to show for SN9 is the latest build diagram from Brendan Lewis as always. Great work by him on these diagrams. You can see SN9 sections are pretty much just ready for stacking now. The very final thing I want to throw in here to show you is this absolutely epic shot of the construction yard. You have SN6 on the left with SN5 just to the right of it, both being flight proven tanks. Then you've also got a stacked but unfinished SN8 tank and the newest of them, the first stacked section for SN9. As always, an enormous thank you to Mary, otherwise known as Boca Chica Girl, for going out there and filming. Also, an enormous thank you to the rest of the NASA spaceflight team who do awesome work behind the scenes. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.